Hi, and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be serving two purposes. I'm going to be talking to you about my current body care favorites, and every single one of these products would also make a wonderful holiday gift. So this is a combination holiday gift guide and body care roundup of what I am currently using. I personally love to get body care as gifts. I love to give it as a gift. I think it's just a really nice way of telling your friend, your loved one, that they deserve to take care of themselves and take some time out for themselves. So as I was preparing for this video, I realized that there are a lot of body care products. So I had to decide where to start and where to stop with the body care. I'm actually going to start with scrubs, body scrubs, and end with hand treatments. I'm not going to go into body washes, soaps, anything like that. Like I said, I'm going to start with a body scrub. So let's start with one of my absolute favorites that I have going right now that I also feel like is just one of my favorites of all time is the Granita de Café body scrub from Jordan Samuel. Now, I think this is a brand new jar. I just finished one recently that was in an empties video. And this one is new. I think maybe I stuck my finger in it a little bit, but I don't think I've actually started this one yet. And there are two reasons why I love this scrub so much. First off is the scent. It just smells like you just walked into the most divine espresso bar, coffee house. The scent is rich and aromatic, and if you love coffee-scented things, particularly coffee-scented scrubs, I can't recommend this one highly enough. Jordan specifically used coffee seed oil in his formulation rather than coffee grounds because if you've ever used a coffee ground base scrub in your shower, you know that it makes a huge mess. So he used the oil instead of the grounds, so this does not make a big mess in your shower. The scrubbing action comes from sugar and salt. And then this is in a base of mango and shea butter, so it's very, very thick and creamy. I think there's also green tea extract in here as well. So it's very thick and creamy. What I usually do is I scoop out a chunk and then I let the water kind of run on it so it emulsifies, it gets a little bit thinner because it is so thick and creamy. And it just feels so amazing on the skin. It really nourishes, moisturizes, does a great job of exfoliation. And sometimes actually the butter can get a little thick on your skin, so you really do need to emulsify it. I do kind of wonder if that is why Jordan is tweaking the formula a little bit. I know that he's rolling out this particular formula and he's bringing in a new one. I think he also really wants to keep the cost down. So I'll be really curious to see what the new formula looks like. Because he is moving these out to bring in the new ones, this is currently on sale for $17 on his website. And I think he's doing 20% off right now for Black Friday. So with 20% off, it would be $13.60. So that is an incredible value for this product. I really, really love it. I don't have on hand right now my other favorite body scrub, which is from Live Botanical, the Lavender Cocoa Body Polish. I think that's what she calls it. But anyway, I love that one. I've spoken about it many, many times on my channel. I don't have it with me right now to show you, but I am planning on getting it during her holiday sale. So my previous video was all about Live Botanical, all about the beautiful collection she has going, as well as a limited edition box that's going to be with Boxwalla. I don't know if the 25% off code is still going to be good, but you just use my name, T-R-I-S-H, and you get 25% off during her sale, which I think goes till November 30th. But if it's past then, you can actually still use my code and get 20% off. It's no longer 15% off, it's moving to 20% off, so that is great. So yeah, I am planning on getting the body scrub during her sale, and I'm really excited to get that back into my life. So the next thing I want to talk about are lotions, and I have two of them. I really gravitate towards lotions when I'm in a hurry, when I need to go to work and get dressed right away. I also like to use lotions if I want to put a lotion on my body, but I'm not just stepping out of the shower. I feel like lotions tend to sink in better on dry skin than oils do, of course. So let's talk about the first one. This is the CV Skin Labs. This is their body repair lotion. It is $36 for 6 ounces, so a little bit on the expensive side. And I usually get it like at Detox Market, I think, or Credo. So when they have their sales going on, that is when I will pick up a few of these. It is designed for dry, flaky, fragile skin. There is aloe, olive fruit oil, mushroom extract, rosehip oil, St. John's wort extract, turmeric and beeswax. So keep that in mind that this is not a vegan formulation. I am just so in love with this product. It's been a long time favorite. The texture is on the thin side. It's very lotiony. It absorbs very quickly. It has a beautiful scent of almost kind of like a vanilla tonka kind of scent. And I have reviewed the ingredient list so many times because I'm just like, where is this beautiful scent coming from? I can't figure it out, but all I know is it just has this really beautiful kind of sweet, earthy smell that I have grown to really, really love. So I highly recommend this lotion. Another one that I recommend, this is a new favorite. This is from Kewutzin Made. I don't know if I'm pronouncing the name correctly. It is an indigenous name and this is an indigenous owned brand. So yeah, I really don't know if I'm pronouncing it correctly, but this is their Devil's Club Lotion with comfrey and nettle. This is $15 for 2.5 ounces. There is shea butter in here. There's apricot kernel oil that is infused with the Devil's Club comfrey and nettle. Now, Devil's Club is used to soothe the skin. And I want to point out that Devil's Club is an ancestral plant of the woman who owns Kewutzin Made. There's also avocado oil, nettle extract, and essential oil of cedar in here. And the scent, you guys, is just, oh, it is so therapeutic for me. I really love cedar so much. It has been a favorite of mine for a really long time. And I'm finding right now during this pandemic time, it is even more soothing and comforting than ever. So if you are a cedar fan, I highly recommend this lotion. Before we jump into oils, I want to give a quick shout out to this Fine Body Serum. I have already mentioned this a couple times. I will link to that review above here, but I just want to tell you that I am loving this body serum. It's from Fine Cosmetics. This is in the limited edition box that the box wall has going with Fine. So like I said, I'm not going to dive into that. Go check out my video that features the limited edition boxes that Boxwell is doing right now if you want more information. But I just wanted to say that I'm absolutely in love with this serum, and I do think that that box would make an excellent, excellent gift. So as far as body oils go, I am head over heels in love with the Infiore Firmante Elevating Leg Tonic. This is quite a splurge at $135 for 3.3 ounces. I do a treat to myself every year for my birthday where I purchase some Infiore products. So this was a part of that this last year. I decided to get it because I had never experienced anything from Julie Elliott, the woman who creates these products. I had never experienced anything from her that had kind of a coniferous, piney type scent. And this has, let's see, black spruce and cypress in it. And the reason why these are in here is because they help with circulatory stagnation and they help stimulate the blood and lymphatic flow. And that is what this product is all about, stimulating the flow in your legs. I use this all over my body. It also has echinacea, fennel, alfalfa, dandelion, and horse chestnut in here. So just to reiterate, it's good for invigorating circulation and to restore flow into your legs. There is also a psycho-spiritual component that Julie Elliott talks about that's going to facilitate a conscious urge to find a new direction, guide one towards self-discovery, and stand tall while remaining grounded. Now, I think that the standing tall while remaining grounded is really beautiful, especially when you think about a black spruce that gets incredibly tall and beautiful, but also has deep, deep roots and of course stays grounded. And that is really exuded in this scent. The scent is just beautiful and exquisite. I love it. And like I mentioned, I use it all over my body and I find it does a wonderful job of moisturizing. I actually love combining it with the Kewutzin Made Devil's Club lotion. These two together create an incredible scent experience and they blend really well together and create just a gorgeous emulsion. Another body oil that I adore is the Laurel California Body Lotion. And this one too is a little bit on the expensive side, not quite as expensive as the Infiore. This is $90 for 3.3 ounces, so definitely a splurge. So there are aromatic essential oils in here that are going to have an affinity for lymph and circulating movement. There are raw rich plant oils that regenerate the skin. There's also a house-made gem essence in here with rose quartz and Herkimer diamond, which are gonna help promote self-love and acceptance. And I also think it's really important to note that the olive, almond, sunflower, and avocado oils in here are oils that are pressed in California. And there's also sweet orange, rose, cedar, fir, spruce, and petite grain in here. Those are the essential oils. And the scent profile is just a beautiful balanced blend of all of those essential oils. Nothing actually really sticks out. It's not like you smell it and you think, oh my God, there's so much spruce in here, or there's a lot of rose or a lot of cedar. It just really exudes a feeling of relaxation, but also it's invigorating at the same time. And it just smells very nourishing. And like I said, just all of these essences rolled up into one, just perfectly balanced. I love the feeling of this on my skin. Again, these two combined also make a wonderful, you know, scent experience and moisturize the skin beautifully. I do also want to mention another oil that I have really been enjoying, and this is the Persephone Monoi oil. And this is $64 for 3.3 ounces. And what Monoi is tiare and fleurage in coconut oil. So tiare is Tahitian gardenia. So this is a traditional moisturizer scent from Tahiti. I do think it's important to note though, that because this is coconut oil, when it is cold outside, it definitely solidified. This was just sitting on my windowsill and it's cold outside, so right now it's a solid. So it's not actually going to pump out of here. What I need to do is, if I do want to use this, I have to remember to actually put it on the ledge inside my shower so the steam and the heat helps liquefy it. And then of course in the warm summer months, if you have it on your windowsill and the sun is coming through, it's going to stay in liquid form. Now, even though it is kind of fussy like that, it's worth having that extra effort because the scent is so beautiful. To me, tiare is kind of like a combination of ylang ylang with gardenia, like the gardenia scent that's typically used in perfumes. So I really love this. The coconut oil is beautiful. I love that it's the enfleurage of the tiare flower. So I did want to recommend this, but just beware that if it gets cold, it will solidify because of the coconut oil. Now let's move on to hand treatments. The first one I want to mention is from Fivenia. This is their hand treatment. It is $32 and 1.7 ounces. It contains botanical oils and butters like Kapuaku butter. There's a high concentration of reparative and antimicrobial Chinese medicinal botanicals like honeysuckle and licorice. The scent smells of hinoki fir, holy basil, and spruce. It's supposed to be evocative of forest bathing. I really get hinoki fir from here. And then a little bit of the spruce. It's a beautiful, beautiful scent. You can tell that I have gotten good use out of this, and you really do have to squeeze it pretty hard to get the product out. That's why the tube is pretty banged up here. I got a little bit out here to show you the color and the texture. The texture is super thick, and it truly is a balmy type of hand treatment. In fact, most of the ones that I have here are. Like I said, the scent is gorgeous. It is very sprucey, but I also do get quite a bit of the hinoki in here. I highly recommend this one. I do have an extra one of these that has never been used that I am planning to give one of you in a giveaway. So like I mentioned in a couple videos ago, I'm super, super close to 3K subscribers, and I will be doing some amazing giveaways when I hit that milestone. So if you haven't yet subscribed, please do. I would really appreciate it. So let's move on to the next hand treatment. This is from 54 Thrones. This is their butter, and I have the scent of Egyptian lavender and Moroccan mint, which is so beautiful. I love the scent. This is $24 for 1.7 ounces. There are two types of shea in here. There's shea nilotica and then shea. There's baobab oil, avocado oil, and then of course the oils of lavender and mint. This is another one of those tubes where you have to squeeze pretty hard to get product out. And then this texture too is really smooth, really creamy. I would say that this one is a little bit looser of a texture than the Fivenia. The Fivenia is definitely more like a stiff balm. This one is definitely on the looser, kind of juicier side. And I am just so in love with the scent, as I mentioned. The lavender is really soft, it's very pretty, and the mint actually is not super strong. It just kind of seems like it's there to help heighten the lavender, or at least that's my experience of it. And it just leaves your hands feeling so smooth. My hands right now feel amazing after using these two hand treatments. I do want to mention another hand treatment that I've really been enjoying. This is the Heal from Beneath Your Mask. Cute little tube of that, perfect for travel or putting in your bag. This is 1 ounce for $28. This has shea butter, cloudberry seed oil, avocado oil, jojoba oil, lemongrass, lavender, and tea tree oil. The scent for me is truly all about the lemongrass. I don't really smell lavender or the tea tree oil in here. I'm not gonna put this onto my hands because I already have these two hand treatments going, but I will tell you, like I said, the scent is very strongly lemongrass. You do have to squeeze the tube pretty hard, similar to the Fivenia. The 54 Thrones, I would say you don't have to squeeze quite as hard, but with the Fivenia and the Beneath Your Mask, especially when it's colder outside, you do have to squeeze pretty hard. So I would say if you have arthritis or you have hand pain and it's difficult for you to squeeze really hard, these probably would not be for you, these three particular tube products. So if tubes aren't quite your thing and you'd rather have a jar for your hand treatments, I really recommend this one from Eugenia Shea. This is 2 ounces and is $13.50. So you can see it's in this cute little tin. I got this in Everyday Strength. This is some shea. So the Everyday Strength has 82.5% shea butter, 14.5% shea oil, 2% lavender essential oil, and then there's 0.5% of moringa oil and 0.5% of baobab oil. So this has a very, very smooth, creamy texture. Really not difficult to get out and to use. The scent of the lavender is a little bit sharper than the one in the 54 Thrones, but it is very herbal. It's not too strong. I really love using this at nighttime because for me, lavender is a very comforting scent, as I'm sure it is for a lot of people for bedtime. I'm gonna go ahead and dig my finger in here so that you can see the texture. I'll put it on my palm. It is really, really thick and creamy. This is quite similar to the 54 Thrones texture. And yeah, the smell is really, really beautiful. It is actually on that soft lavender side. I guess it's just compared to the 54 Thrones, it is just a little bit more herbaceous. So beautiful. And like I said, I really like using this at nighttime. Eugenia Shea also offers a dermatologic strength, which is 100% shea butter. And I have heard nothing but great things about that one. So if you have psoriasis or eczema, or you just don't want to have any kind of essential oil in your product, you might want to check that one out as well. So last but not least, I have another hand treatment, and this is from L'Amour. This is their hand butter. L'Amour is a Mongolian brand. The owner is a woman who is from Mongolia. And I really love this brand because they are doing so much to promote the culture of Mongolia, to help support the economy of Mongolia, and their prices are actually very reasonable. So this is 1.41 ounces for $10, so very reasonable. What a great stocking stuffer. This is definitely very creamy. So this is a hand butter. This is definitely a lot softer than the other hand treatments I have mentioned. This is more of like a lotion slash cream. It absorbs into the skin really quickly. And that's probably because there is some water in here. There's water, sunflower oil, beeswax, coconut oil, shea butter, sweet orange oil, and then there is beef tallow in here. So if you're not familiar with L'Amour or you haven't heard me speak about this brand before, they do use beef tallow, other animal products, because that is traditional to Mongolian culture. The animals are treated very respectfully. They live and feed off the land with lots of room to roam. And like I said, they are treated with compassion. And I think that using the beef tallow is just very significant in terms of not wasting any part of the animal and just treating the land and the animals with that respect. So for me, even though I normally wouldn't be drawn to a product that has beef tallow in it, knowing this is part of the Mongolian culture, this is a Mongolian brand, and the money is going to be going back into their economy, and like I said, to promote the Mongolian culture, I'm totally fine with it. Not to mention the fact that it is so good for the skin. It feels incredible on the skin. I think this is probably my third tin. This is a relatively new one that they sent to me, but I have gone through several of them already and I really, really love it. So I highly recommend checking out L'Amour. It is carried at Pink Moon as well as Lily's Bathicary. I think that's the name. But I have really been loving shopping at Pink Moon. Their site is gorgeous. So if you haven't given their website a peek, I really recommend that you do because it's beautiful. It's easy to navigate. And I'm really excited that they are carrying the L'Amour brand there. So that does it for my current favorite body products. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions about anything, please don't hesitate to ask me down below. I am happy to find out any information if I don't have the answer for you at the ready. And thank you guys so much for watching and for all of your support. And I hope you all are staying safe and healthy out there. Bye.